offer my humble pranam at the lotus feet of Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. Welcome to video lecture on assembly language programming in 8085 microprocessor. In this lecture, I'm going to explain how to transfer blocks of data between two memory locations starting from 8900 and 8800. 8900 gives the starting address of source block and 8800 gives the starting address of destination block. Now I'm going to explain the actual program here. So this is the program. Now here write an assembly language program in 8085 microprocessor transfer block of data starting from 8900, that is a source, to 8800, it's nothing but destination, it's nothing but block transfer. Now here in the previous video I explained how to transfer only 2 bytes of data from source to destination by using indirect addressing mode. Therefore, if you want to transfer more than something like a 2 or 3 data bytes, we have to go for an indirect addressing mode. Therefore, if you want to transfer a block of data, so this method is important. We have to go for indirect addressing mode. Using this program, we can able to transfer any number of data bytes, either it may be 100 or it may be 1000 also. Okay. So in this example, I consider how to transfer a 10 bytes of data starting from 8900 to another location, another block of location starting from 8800. So here, move immediate B comma 0. A stands for 10. If I'm loading counter, that is a count, means how many bytes of data to transfer to where? To B register. That's a move immediately to where? To B register. What type of data? That is this 8-bit data to where? To B register. That means after execution of this particular instruction, B becomes 0A. Say 0A in hexadecimal, that is in hexadecimal, okay, that is equal to 10 in decimal. Okay, then I already explained about this instruction. This becomes actually load, LI stands for load immediately to where? To register pair, which register pair? HL, H stands for HL, okay. Then 8850 goes to go to HL register pair, load immediately to where? To register pair, which register pair? HL, which information? This information, it is nothing but starting address of source. Let me here 8900, na? If I'm going to use 8900 here, this is starting address of source according to a problem statement. The starting address of destination is 8800, so let it be as per our problem statement. This is the thing. Now here after execution, executing this particular instruction, HL becomes 8900. Okay, now after execution of this particular instruction, HL becomes 8900. It's an hexadecimal address. In the same manner, that is load immediately. Load immediately. L stand for load. I stand for immediately to where? Register pair. X stands for register pair. Which register pair? DE. Which address? 8800. Once you execute this particular instruction, therefore DE becomes 8800. Okay, understood this? Now move A comma M means transfer data, move data from where? From memory to where? Accumulator, A register. Which memory? That address is given by HL pair. Okay, what is the content of HL? HL contains 8900. Assume 8900 contains one data, let it be, here it's your source block. Assume it contains some 11. It contains some 11. That 11 comes to where? Accumulator, register, accumulator. That is A becomes 11. That's the meaning of this instruction. Transfer data from memory to accumulator. Which memory? Pointed by HL. HL bears like a pointer. What's the value of HL? 8900. It takes you to 8900. What is the content of 8900? 11. That 11 comes to accumulator. That's the meaning of this instruction. Next, here, store the content of accumulator, which contains 11, to where? To memory location. Which memory? That address is given by register pair. Here, X stands for register pair. Which register pair? DE. What is the content of DE? 8800. So, whatever information available in accumulator is going to place that data into where? 8800. 0 0. Okay, 8 a 0 0 becomes 11. Okay, 8 a 0 0 becomes 11. That is the meaning of this instruction. So we transfer one data. One data is get transferred. Then we have to update the pointer. INX H. Then INX D. What is the meaning of INX H? Increment. IN stand for increment. Increment X by X means register pair. Which register pair? HL. Therefore, once if you execute this particular instruction, HL becomes 8901. Then increment the content of DE. That is increment register pair. Which register pair? DE by 1. Therefore, DE becomes what? 8A. That is 8A01. The initial value of D is 8A00. That becomes 8A01. Initial content of HL is 8900. That becomes 890. Means it gives the address of next data. It gives the address of next immediate empty location. That's the meaning of this. So here decrement B. What is the meaning of decrement? DCR means decrement. DCR means decrement the content of B by 1. B is a register, 8-bit register. What is the initial value of B? B contains 10. Now 10 becomes 9. 10 becomes 9. Here I'm going to check. Means once if you execute this particular instruction, it's going to affect zero flag. Okay, we have something called a flag, sign flag, zero flag, parity flag, auxiliary carry flag, all those things. Now here it's we are talking about zero flag. Jump if not zero. Okay, here what is the value of B? B contains 9. Is it equal to 0? No. Therefore, the counter is not equal to 0. Therefore, jump if not 0. Jump if counter is not equal to 0 to where? Next. Okay. Jump if not 0. If the condition is true, we know that 9 is not equal to 0. The content of B is not equal to 0. B contains 9. Nah? If it is not equal to 0, therefore, this condition is true, then it takes you to this particular memory location. There is nothing but next. What is the address of next? 8008. Okay, the address of next is 8008. Then it comes over here. Then move A, M. Means what? Transfer data from memory. Which memory? Which memory pointed by HL? What is the value of HL? Updated value of HL. Not this one. Not this one. Updated value of HL. What is the content of HL? 8901. What is the content of 8901? Suppose assume here 8901 contains some data. What is that data? Let it be 22. Therefore, once if you execute the statement, accumulator becomes 22. Accumulator becomes 22. Then store the content of accumulator, which contains 22, to where? To memory location. Which memory? That address is given by DE. What is the content of DE? 8801. The updated value of DE, 8801. Therefore, it's going to write the content of accumulator into the memory, which memory that address is given by DE. Therefore, now we know that here DE contains 8801. Therefore, 8801 becomes what? 22. The second data is transferred. Then update the value, increment the content of HL by 1. Therefore, now 8901 becomes 8902. Then INXD, increment the content of DE by 1. Increment register pair. Which register pair? DE. By how much? By 1. Therefore, 8801 becomes 8802. It gives address of next immediate location. Okay. Then decrement B. B becomes 8. B becomes 8. Not 0. Jump. If not 0. Jump. Therefore, jump. If not 0, true or false? True, because 8 is not equal to 0, then it takes you to next. It's going to repeat same thing. Therefore, 8 becomes a 7, a 7 becomes 6, 6 becomes 5, like this. Finally, what happened? Finally, it becomes what? 0. Okay, finally, it becomes 7 becomes what? Here, that is 6, this becomes a 5, etc. Like it becomes finally 0, 0. Okay. Finally, it becomes 0. Then I'm checking here in the last iteration. Then this is 0. This condition is false. Jump if not 0 to where? Go to next. Okay. If the condition is false, comes out. It comes out of the loop. If once B equal to 0, the counter equal to 0, then the condition is false, then comes out. If it is true, go back. If it is false, comes out of the loop. Therefore, it is going to execute this particular loop how many times? 10 times. Okay, you can able to use same program to transfer 100 data byte also. Just we have to change, instead of 0, you have to put 100. That's the meaning of this. Okay, understood? Then after coming out of this, it's going to execute RST5. Then it's going to terminate the program. Understood this? Now just I'm going to give the demo for this. Okay, now I'm going to give the demo for this. Now they enter that program, the complete program starting from 8000 exam memory, 8000, here 8000. So this is the program. 06 is the hexadecimal code for move immediate B. Then 08 is a counter. Then LXIH, then 5088. Actually, here as per our program, this I consider 89. Therefore, here instead of 50, this must be 00. Then next. Here 89, then next LXID, that's a code for LXID is 11, then 50, here we have to give 00 according to the problem. Here 8A, then 7E, move A comma M, then 12 STXD, then 23 INXH, then INXD, then decrement B, jump on not 0, C2. C2 is the code for what? Jump if not 0. Then next 08 is the address of next. Okay, low order byte address 08. Then harder byte address is 80. Therefore, here jump on not 0, C2. Then 08 and 80. 8008 is the address of next. Okay, I have to find out. Okay, just go through that program. So note down this address. Address of next. I have to insert here. Jump on not 0. 0880. Actual address is what? 8008, 8008. Therefore, first we have to write low order byte. Next, we have to write high order byte address. Therefore, here C2 is the code for jump if not 0, then 08, then 80, then EF. Okay. Now, just you can see once again exam memory 8000, 06, 21, 0089, 11, 0080. 7E, yes, this is the address of next. 8008 is the address of next. If the condition is true, then I have to come back and start from here onwards. Here this is a complete code for this. Okay, then go to exam memory 8900. Then I'm going to enter the input. What's the initial value? Here we have some something 00, see up to 090A. So I have to enter starting from 0 to 9. 0 to 9 means 10 data bytes, therefore we'll start from here. Okay, here I'll try start from 1, then 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 8. Okay, then if you want, you can check once again exam memory 8900. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 8. Okay, then check the initial content of 8800. Here 00000 till A. Okay, all are 0 only. Now go starting address of the program, execute, then exam memory 8A00. 8A00. Then you can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 8. The program means block is transferred successfully without any problem. Okay, you can try this. Okay, this is the way of transferring block of data from one memory to another memory using indirect addressing mode. In the next lecture, I'm going to explain how to transfer, means how to exchange data between two memory location by using direct addressing mode. Okay, thanks for watching.